This video is part of my Udemy courses. See the description for more info. Hi there, in this lecture we're gonna play around with the room editor and learn more about it. We're gonna go into our project and open our room so that we are inside the room editor. Here we have our instances and you can move them around horizontally and vertically. So you can see that a room is two-dimensional. There are two dimensions here, one horizontal and the other vertical. The horizontal dimension is the x-axis and the vertical dimension is the y-axis. This is our two-dimensional space in our room where the game takes place. Now the room starts at the top left corner where the x and the y are 0 and 0 and it ends at the bottom right corner. Here the x is equal to the width of the room and the y is equal to the height of the room. Now you can see the x and y coordinates at any point in the room by hovering your mouse over it and reading the coordinates down here. This is the x and this is the y. Now I'll go to the top left corner of the room. So that's 0 and 0. And I'll move my mouse to the right. As I do that, you can see that the x value is increasing. When I move my mouse to the left, then the x starts decreasing. So this is how we move on the x-axis. We increase the x value to go right, and we decrease the x to go left. Now let's see how it works on the y-axis. If I start going down, then the y value increases, and if I start going up, then the y value decreases. So that's how we move on the y-axis. We increase the y value to go down, and we decrease it to go up. Now understanding this is important because movement is an integral part of games and we use these x and y axes to move an instance. So that's how 2D coordinates work in a GameMaker room and you can move these instances to any position on these axes. It is moving within a grid right now, so you can turn that off by clicking here and you can now freely move these instances anywhere. You can then double click on an instance to open its properties. And here you can see its x and y coordinates. Changing any of these values is going to move the instance on that axis. So you can see how the x and y coordinates of an instance determine where it is in the room. So that's enough about movement. Now let's take a look at some other things. You can change the scale of an instance to make it bigger or smaller. And you can also rotate it. As I rotate this instance, you can see that it's rotating around this point because that's the origin of the sprite. Now we can change the origin by going into the sprite properties. This point that you see here is the origin point. You can move it around to change it or you can set it through this menu. So you have some options here from top left to bottom right and I'm gonna select middle center. So the origin point is now at the center of the image. Let's go back into the room editor and rotate this instance again. And you'll see that it now rotates around the center point because that is the new origin of the sprite. This is also important because it's not just about rotation. If this is the origin point, it means that this is the actual position of the instance in the room. So the x and y coordinates of the instance are actually at this point. Now let's take a look at the layers section here. We have been placing our instances in this instance layer. So this is the layer that currently contains all of our instances. And here we have another layer called background. So this is a simple background layer. We can click on it to select it and we can change its color from here. So whatever color you set here is gonna be the new background color. So these are the two default layers that you have in a room and you can create more layers using these buttons. Each one of these buttons is a different layer type and the ones we are currently using is an instance layer and a background layer. Now another important setting is the size of the room which can be found down here. Here you're gonna see the default room width and height but you can set them to whatever you like. So for example I can set it to 800 by 600 and now the room has become smaller. You can go to the bottom right corner of the room and you'll see that the coordinates stop at 800 by 600. So that is the size of the room now. I'm gonna go back into the instances layer where we have our instances. These instances will appear in the game, so when you run it, you're gonna see the instances in the room. But because we haven't programmed anything yet, everything in our game is pretty static and nothing happens at all. So you might be wondering, how do you make these instances respond to your inputs, or how do you program their behavior? Well, even if you've never programmed before, you might know that you give commands to the computer by coding. But the question is, when do you give those commands? And that is where events come in. With events, you can run some code when the player presses a specific key, so that's how the instance can respond to your input, or you can run some code every frame of the game, so the instance can exhibit some behavior of its own. To do all that, you have to make use of events within an object. So events will enable us to program these instances, and we're going to use them in the next lecture. I hope you enjoyed the video. You can watch more tutorials from here, and make sure to subscribe for more GameMaker content. I'll see you in the next video.